Well, look at me, with my fiery sword and all looking badass. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. If you are playing this game and you see people walking around with items and gear like this, and you think, "Okay, how did they get that?" I will show you. These are all items that you can get from your Hall of Monuments based on the achievements in Guild Wars 1. I will show you how you get there and what you have to do. I'm here in Lion's Arch, as you can see, and in the left bottom corner, right over there, there's a karma vendor, and he sells some sort of a special stone, and with that stone you can teleport through your Hall of Monuments. I will show you how to go. I will speed up the run and give you guys a little bit more background information about the Hall of Monuments. The Hall of Monuments in Guild Wars 1 was a place that was introduced when they brought the patch Eye of the North, or the expansion. And what you could do, you could display all your titles there, and yeah, for fame, and you unlocked statues that way. And later on, when they announced Guild Wars 2, they said you could earn things in Guild Wars 2 with your achievements in the Hall of Monuments. So after that, lots of people rushed to complete all those achievements. And based on all the stuff that you unlocked in Guild Wars 1, yeah, there are some nice things that you can do with it. As you can see, we're here now at the vendor. This guy, that's the guy you want to talk to. And he has two back things. This is the normal one. And the second back contains this thing. And this is some sort of teleportation stone that will bring you to Eye of the North. The only thing you have to do is just click on it. And here we go. And this is where it will take you. The Eye of the North, 250 years from the last expansion. As you can see, it's in a pretty bad state. Here are the chests where you stored your items in Guild Wars 1. As you can see, this is the old one. It's in a in a much better state. And here we have the same chests. I even got some items in it. Back to reality of today. As you can see, I'm walking towards where normally all your statues are displaced. This is it in Guild Wars 1. As you can see, it's pretty ruined. The whole thing is filled with water. Spider webs everywhere. And the curtains with the titles are gone. This was it back in the days. All the weapons cost me quite some hectares. Some titles or some armor. But what you want to do, you want to talk to this guy. This was the historian. You saw him in the you saw a glimpse of him in his fleshy form back in Guild Wars 1. But you want to talk to this guy, and he basically has all the skins you need for transforming your armor, and he also has the PvP stuff. I unlocked everything, so I will buy everything, and I will show you how they look. As you can see, I have the full heavy armor. I transformed it into that look. Into the heritage look, except the bracers. I replaced them with the ones you get when you have 30 home points. And here you can see the fiery sword, it looks amazing, and also the warhorn. I don't have any light or medium armor wearers, so I can't so show you that, but I will first show you the mini pets. This is the raccoon, sweet little thingy, and this is the undead chicken, or that's how I call him. Yeah, you have to decide for yourself, but I don't really like this. This is, I think, much better, the mini golem. And last in line is the cat. As you saw earlier in this video, in Guild Wars 1 I was wearing an axe, that was the skin, that was this skin. And I bought two of them from the guy in the pool, the Historican. And I will transform these two axes with the skin from Guild Wars 1. How it works is, it's very simple, you just drag and drop your item into here and then you can transform it. It's yeah, it are only looks, so you won't change any stats or something. And this is how they look now. You have to decide for yourself, but I like the look from Guild Wars 1 better than this, because they are pretty small compared to the fiery sword. Yeah, that looks just absolutely badass. But yeah, it works like this. It's very simple. You just I'll show it again with the horn, and here you have it, the new worn horn. Pretty nice thing. Okay, I will show you the rest of the stuff. This is the fell blade. There was a one-handed sword back in the days. Now they made it a two-hander. It looks exactly the same as in Guild Wars 1, only then it's a two-hander. Unfortunately, you are not able to dye your weapons at this point. I hope they change it. This is the Icebreaker, a hammer. It looks amazing. Next in line is the mace. Yeah, pretty badass mace. I don't like the color, but I hope they bring out some patch or some special thing that you can dye your weapons. This is, I think, also absolutely looking fantastic. The longbow. And then I will continue with... I can't wear this, so I have to show it in preview form. Looks okay. Focus. Yeah, I don't really like this. Oh, sorry, this is a pistol. The pistol. And then we have the staff. Yeah, that looks very nice. Look at the detail, the spiry thingy over there. And this is the torch. Yeah, I don't like this. I thought it would spit fire or something, but maybe it's because I'm wearing it in the preview mode. This is the gun. Looks pretty old. It looks okay, but I found guns that looked better or much better than this already, and that were just yeah, stuff you found when leveling. Oh, this is also a very nice looking thing, the shield, the diamond Aegis. Check it out, combined with the fiery sword. And just remember, you can buy those skins from the guy in the pool, the Historican, for 0 copper, and you can buy them over and over again. So yeah, you can transform your gear constantly. I will show you guys how much light those fiery swords give off. I'm running towards a pretty dark spot over here, and then I will just switch to that sword. Look at that. It's like turning on and off a light switch. And as a warrior, you can equip two of those blades. It's pretty cool. If you then walk inside the dark place, like a cave, then you just switch to your fiery swords and you can see everything again. So that is how the Hall of Monuments works. Just keep in mind that you can still complete titles in Guild Wars 1 and get your home to at least to 30 points, and then you have all the items. Titles are a different thing, but titles aren't displayed at the moment, so it's a bit bugged. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I see you next time. Arrivederci.